good afternoon and thanks for joining me on this beautiful warm Sunday in Brixton. Later on today I'm heading over to Camden to KOKO to go and see the wonderful, kawaii, amazing Kyary Pamyu Pamyu. But first, you might have seen my last video. I've just been to see Maison Book Girl. Last night they were playing near Camden, today they were doing an in-store over here at Banquet Records, so I've just been in. I will get to Kyary Pamyu Pamyu stuff, but I think it's very important if you're watching this video and you haven't heard of or seen Maison Book Girl, you probably should check them out. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to drop in a quick little live performance from the show they've just done. Back in a minute. See, wasn't that actually amazing? They are awesome. But anywho, I'm gonna wrap this up now and I'm gonna head to Camden. I will see you outside KOKO. I suddenly feel massively underdressed. It's always the way with Kyary Pamyu Pamyu concerts though, people go all out. If only I own the pastel pink t-shirt next time. Anyway, I'm hot, I'm sweaty, I'm gonna go back to the hotel and get changed and then maybe join this mammoth queue. Oh boy, this queue got big. Before, like, there's like the side of KOKO and it was like down there and it wasn't very long, and now it's ridiculous. Oh well, need to join it. But first, let's go through a bit of background on Kyary Pamyu Pamyu. I think compared to a lot of Japanese artists, she's probably one of the more well-known overseas. If you found this video, it's probably because you know her and like her. But if you found this video just because it's one of our videos, I think next to Baby Metal, maybe they're sort of one of the more popular acts. She's awesome and mental. Which, if you watch any of her music videos, like Pon Pon Pon's got something like about 400 million views or something ridiculous. That's a really good illustration. She calmed down recently, I think, but still has that harajuku kawaii sort of weird sort of look about her. It's produced by Yasutaka Nakata, who is a Capsule, if you know them, who also produces another amazing act, Perfume, amongst others. So I saw Kyary Pamyu Pamyu, I think this is the fourth time she's been to the UK. A couple of years ago she was over for Moshi Moshi Nippon Fest, and she had a gorilla DJing for her, who it was later turned out was actually Yasutaka Nakata, which is awesome, because now I can say I've seen him live, kind of. It's part of the her sort of Halloween tour, this as well, so I'm not sure how this works, because we're in May. But anyway, enough of this, I'm going to go and join that ridiculous queue. And yeah, and head in, see you inside. Just to sort of clarify, that's where the queue was before. Now it's... yeah, I can't even see the end of it. got my king blades ready. These don't get to come out that often, so any excuse. Guess who forgot his ticket and had to go and get it and is now at the back of the queue? This guy. Idiot. I'd be at least 8.5 minutes closer if I'd remembered my ticket. So close. So very close. Ooh. That queue was almost too long and I nearly missed it. Right, I am in, it's packed, but I can't believe how reasonably priced the merchandise was. When I went to see her at the Roundhouse, I remember t-shirts were up to like £35. And the max this time, they had some for 20, some for 25. They had flipping towels for a tenner, muffler for £10. I'm so happy. Right, but anyway, perks of being on your own at a gig like this. You can actually sort of wind your way closer to the front, so I'm gonna go and try that. Wish me luck.
Red. Yeah! were like, ah, crazy party night of love. ラップが入ってるのでそこにも注目して聞いていただけたらいいなと思います。それでは聞いてください。kimi の mitaka。